Hello everyone, on this video we will look at Aws Lambda Functions. And Lambda Functions are really just actions that you can have triggered by some other actions. So the goal of this example is to drop a file into one S3 bucket, which will then trigger a Lambda function that will actually push that uploaded data to our stream that we created in the previous video. That means it will go from the stream to Firehose to the new bucket. So a lot happening at once, but let's go through it step by step. Now some other prerequisites here, and here are the different roles that we have. Now two other new services we'll be looking at are SNS, which is a messaging system, and CloudWatch, which will allow us to really monitor and review what the functions are actually doing, and it'll help us debug and move our way through this. So step one, let's create from scratch. We'll give it a name, S3 to Kinesis. We will use Python. And we will allow Lambda to create a new role with all of the permissions so that we don't have to worry about that specifically for this example. Here's the base view that we're looking at. Now if we hop back in here, if we look at our roles, we can refresh and we'll see this new role is here. We want to make sure this role has full permissions to both S3, to Kinesis, and to SNS. We don't want any issues here in terms of it being denied access to any of these things that we're going to be working with here in this example. So let's give it all of those. Let's add a trigger, in this case S3. It will be our upload bucket. So anytime something gets put in to this bucket, it will trigger this function that we create. In the destination, we just want it to have a topic. So we'll create a topic here. And call it demo SNS, create. Let's try again. It should recognize it now, and there it is. So let's put that here as our destination. So as soon as something gets put in S3, it will trigger this function that we are going to create and send a notification to the SNS service. All right, so let's now scroll down and take a look at the actual function. To test this out, let's just put in a message here, print success, and that way we can test it. All right, so let's add a file. Just going to add this team CSV file that we've worked on in the past on previous videos. So now that it just got dropped, we expect something to happen. We expect this to fire, but in our case, nothing's going to happen other than printing that success message. So let's go and explore this. Let's check this out. We can see there is a log event, and there it is. It printed success. That's good. That means this function was triggered and it executed. But now we want it to actually do something. We don't want it to just, you know, that doesn't really add any value of printing. Let's add some sort of logic here. And this is where you could actually get into some very simple ETL type of work, different transforms, whatever. So for the sake of time, I've copied and pasted a script that I've pre-written, and I will walk through this a bit with you and also provide this in a GitHub. And essentially what this is doing is it's parsing through the events JSON object, reading the content, capturing each of the columns, and then allowing us to create a custom JSON record. So if you look at the bottom here, what we're saying here is as soon as something gets uploaded to our source bucket, it will trigger this Lambda function. Now this Lambda function, this code that it's looking at, is creating a custom JSON object and ultimately pushing it to our Kinesis stream. Now we also have our Kinesis stream hooked up to Firehose, and Firehose will land it in another S3 bucket. And the idea here is it's going from a raw data to being slightly transformed in a cleaner, more consistent JSON object, and then landing in that new S3 bucket. So it's a lot happening, but you know, once it's set up, it's pretty cool how it all works together. Now, to help show you what this actually looks like, I'll print out these different objects from the events. So we'll say event object, the bucket, and the CSV key. And we'll also print out just the full event, so the entire raw data event. And this is something we'll be able to monitor in CloudWatch so that we can see what it looks like. So I'm going to comment everything else out. So we'll just have those printed objects. We're not actually going to process anything, just going to print out what the event looks like. So now I just uploaded a new one, which should again trigger another Lambda function, but this time it's printing out more information. So let's go to our logs here and check it out. And here it is. So now you can see what this new event record looks like and start to see what we're trying to parse out. You can see the records, which is what we're looking at there. Traverses down into the bucket name. There's S3 and then the bucket and then name. So that's kind of how we're drilling down into this object, etc. This is how we know what actual elements we're actually concerned with here. Now we have an error that says source is not defined. And that is from a typo. But you can just understand that that would display the name of the bucket if I didn't mistype it. So now let's save and run the whole thing and see what happens. This data will get dropped into the upload bucket, which will trigger this Lambda function. This Lambda function is going to push the information to the stream and therefore through Firehose and land into a new bucket. Okay, so we uploaded it. This should trigger this function, which again will push it to our stream, which will do the rest. We can look at our logs. I think that was the wrong one. There we go. So we have a success here. We should see something now. There we go. So that means that upload was successfully triggered the Lambda function that pushed it to the stream. Now if we go to the other bucket, this should be the cleaned version. And there it is. It dropped it in here. And this actual record should look a little better than the raw data, which if you remember was just, you know, had a lot of metadata with it. This should just be what we want. There it is. ID, team, city. So it makes it then much easier for a future ETL process to filter that out. Now this is a very simple example, but you can imagine as you get a ton of data happening in real time, this allows you to capture it, have a trigger, and automatically move it to a new bucket that's much cleaner and easier to work with. So I know that was a lot in one video. I hope you found it helpful. Please leave comments if there are any questions, and happy to help. Thanks for watching.